So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكِ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. And this statement by itself is amazing. And every Muslim should have this memorized. When I go to churches, I tell them this is the equivalent of John 3:16. We see 3:16 everywhere. Go to a sports, watch a football game, you see it written everywhere. What does it mean? This is the essence of our belief about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. 21:107 of the Quran. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. So we did not send you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the second person in the Quran. He doesn't say, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مُحَمَّدًا. Kaful khitab. We did not send you. It's very personal. Speaking directly to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Illa, an exception. For strong emphasis, rahmatan, nakira, it's indefinite, unlimited mercy, unfathomable mercy, mercy that is not restricted, mercy to everything. Interestingly enough too, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ulama point out, he uses a noun here, he doesn't use a verb. He doesn't say, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَكَ إِلَّا أَن تَرْحَمَ الْعَالَمِينَ or something like that. We didn't send you except that you show mercy to people. Allah says, you are mercy. You are rahmatan. This is your that. This is your essence. That's your mercy. Lil alameen. To all of the worlds. So he uses the indefinite article. The mercy of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is something that is unrestricted. Something that is unbelievable. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one time he came into the masjid and he saw a man and he was broken hearted in the masjid in tears. And the Prophet ﷺ said, what's wrong with you? And he said, oh, I've done this and I've done that. He said, I don't want to hear it. Just come here. Just come over here. Let's sit. Raise your hands. Repeat after me. Allahumma maghfiratuk awsa' min dhunubi. Pray this dua with me. Oh Allah, your forgiveness is more vast than my sins, my transgressions. And he said, qum qad ghafara Allahu lak. Now stand up, your sins have been forgiven. The Prophet ﷺ had a deep concern for the ummah, not just for the ummah, a deep concern for all of humanity, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When he was repeating that verse all night long, in to adhibhum fa innahum ibaduk wa in taghfir lahum fa innaka antal aziz wal hakim. Our mother Aisha said that he recited this verse the whole night. Qama Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam bi ayatin min al-Quran layla. The entire night he's reciting this verse. If you punish them, they are your servants. But if you forgive them, if you forgive them, then you are great and wise. And then she said he collapsed into sajda. Collapsed. And she heard him say, Allahumma ummati. Allahumma ummati. Praying for the ummah. Allahumma. What does it mean? It's a vocative address. The ulama say, when you say Allahumma, it means you're calling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by all of His names and attributes. The ones you don't, the ones you know, and the ones you don't know.